Matthew 10 and verse 5 says, "These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, Go not in the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as ye go, preach, saying, The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the leper, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely you have received, freely give. All praise be to the Most High, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob." And I'm going to continue on sharing some brief insight regarding my spiritual beliefs. I am a Hebrew Israelite from the seed of Abraham, from the tribe of Judah. That's where my lineage can be traced back to, from the tribe of Judah. And that's where African American lineage can be traced back to. Christ said, according to Revelation 5 and 5, He is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. And Hebrews 7 and 14 says, "It is evidence that our Lord sprang from the tribe of Judah." So Christ even makes it very clear that He has a lineage, and it can be traced back to the African-American lineage. So don't be surprised if your local church don't tell you this to those who happen to be on a spiritual journey and you receive revelation and you are at a public church and you don't realize, if you happen to be African-American, that Christ came out of your lineage. So if you happen to be viewing this video and you receive a revelation that Christ is a black man from the tribe of Judah, rejoice, because He said, "For I did not come but into the lost sheep of the house of Israel." And you have to accept that if He chose to come into the world as a black man to His people, you have to accept it and receive it and praise the Lord that He chose to come in that manner. Okay? So I'm going to go back to Matthew's 10 and verse 5. This is when the apostles comes on the scene, when Christ commissioned only them. See, He said, "These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, Go not to the way of the Gentiles." I'm going to stop right there. It's very important that you understand the stories of Christ and who He was talking to and who He was sent for and who He gave the power to. Because a lot of times when you see a lot of ministries on TV, a lot of times those who happen to be on the center end don't understand that the time that we're living in and the time that Christ was residing in, we are in completely two different times. Christ was not talking to everyone when you start reading His message in the New Testament. He was only talking to these people I'm going to show you very quickly. Matthew 15 verse 24 says, "But He answered and said, I am not sent but into the lost sheep of the house of Israel." See, He was only talking to those people. He was only sent for those people. He was only proclaiming His Father's doctrine that He gave to Christ to give as a reminder to His people, because what He was speaking was from the Old Testament. He wasn't speaking anything new. He was only reminding the rebellious house of Israel to repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. That can be found in Matthew 4 and verse 17. That was His first message, His words that He was proclaiming throughout Galilee. And He only commissioned His 12. He sent forth. And He gave them some instruction. See, He commanded them. He even told them where to go. He said, "Go not into the way of the Gentiles." See, He said, don't even go to them. He said, "And into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not." He said, don't even go into those regions where the Samaritans are residing. But He said, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And He even gave them the message to preach. Saying, the kingdom, He said, preach first. Preach. Saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And then, guess what? Here is the benefits. He even gave them the power. So, heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely you have received, freely give. So, guess what? He sent them out. See? Can you see that? And He forbid them not to go in the way of the Gentiles. Make sure you have a pen and pad and write this down. And He said, when you see the Samaritans, He said, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not. So it would be them, the regions that they were residing in, not to go into their towns. He said, but go, verse 6 says, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as you go, preach. See? He said, preach. He didn't say teach. He said, preach, although they would be teaching. But in this case, he said, he commanded them to preach. And he even gave them the words, the message to proclaim. And this is the message. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. And then here are the benefits. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely I receive, freely give. So you have to be very careful when you encounter someone that claims to be, quote, a religious leader and preaching the doctrine of Christ. You need to hurry up and put your discernment on and see if they were truly sent like the disciples were. And make sure you evaluate the message, because he was only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, and he is still sent to the people that were chased out of the land of Canaan in 70 AD. He's only talking to them in this society and to those who believe in his doctrine of the disciples. Those are the only people that's going to be saved. If you don't believe me, after this video, stop. Reread and reevaluate the scriptures. I promise you, you will get a more biblical understanding once you continue on reading from where this video stops. You're going to be surprised to see that Christ was only talking to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, even in this modern day society. And then he gave them the message. You want to make sure you discern these spiritual leaders. Do they have the message of Christ? Are they preaching the gospel accordingly? And make sure that it's the message starts off, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. If they're not preaching the kingdom of heaven is at hand, then that is a sign that they are not truly called to preach the gospel of Christ, because Christ made it very clear throughout his message, throughout the New Testament, and even through the apostles' writings, that Israel is promised the kingdom. And this is the message that he gave to his disciples. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. And make sure that you discern if the spiritual leaders are truly called to preach the gospel of Christ. Make sure they have the power, because Christ gave the disciples the power. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely you have received and freely give. If they don't have the power, then that is a sign that that is a false leader that's manipulating the public, because Christ was only sent to lost sheep of the house of Israel, and he only commissioned his disciples. But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. See, it's very easy to understand the doctrine of Christ if you don't take the scriptures out of context. He wasn't talking to any of our modern-day local churches. He was only talking, only teaching, and he was only proclaiming it to these people right here. The lost sheep of the house of Israel. May the Most High bless you this morning. And when this video stops, make sure you continue to research, compare scriptures. Make sure you have a pen and pad and reevaluate what you just viewed on this short, brief video. All praise be to the Most High.